if we weren't, if Pete were not a Toastmaster and I were, and I brought him to a meeting with, and we knew each other well enough, and we had that close personal relationship, and I nudged him to get up and do a table topic because I knew he'd enjoy it. That's one thing. But for a table topics master to pick on a guest and say, "Would you like to volunteer tonight?" That's not volunteering, that's putting somebody on the spot. And you don't want to do that, because if you don't know them, maybe it'll scare them and they won't come back. They might get up and do it, but they might not come back again. So you really don't want to put anybody on the spot. And what we usually do at the beginning of table topics is we say, you know, guests are welcome to participate. And if you would like to participate, raise your hand and I'll be happy to call on you. But I'm not going to put anybody on the spot. You know, you do that at the beginning, you've gotten it out of the way. Because I've seen people stand up and they wait for volunteers and nobody volunteers, and then they pick on a guest. That's not good. We could go over a lot of other things. How many us is there? Anybody count? What did Darren McCoy say about us and us?
Don't count.
Right. Well. Grammarian report, Occam's report, timekeeper reports. Anybody ever been in a meeting where someone turns a grammarian report into a 5 to 7 minute speech or longer? And we want to encourage people when they're in meetings and they're giving their reports to be succinct. What we usually want to do is just pick out the things that are a little bit more outstanding than others, both affirmative as well as opportunities. Not beat everybody over the head about every single syllable or pronunciation that they gave and stood up to speak. Let's talk about how do we do this, because last meeting we talked about what do we do, and we didn't spend as much time talking about how to do it. So I got a couple tips that I'm going to share. These are best practices. And they are not PowerPoint presentations. I'm going to sit down while I do this, if I may. Yeah. One of the things that saved me a heck of a lot of work and frustration was to make a speaking schedule. And because what would happen was, as VPE, I found myself working under a windmill. And the meeting would come around before I knew it, and all the roles had not been scheduled. So what I did was I came up with a speaking schedule. And what I did was I put the days of the meetings down this side. You can see kickoff educational session, club contest, 5-year celebration, whatever it is we're going to do at the different meetings are. The names of the members are listed down this side. And then if I wanted to have 3 speakers per meeting, I scheduled 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And this took me about 45 minutes to do. And I sent it out to everybody in the club. And I said, here's the speaking schedule for the next 15 meetings or whatever. Everybody has their own speaking slot. I've just given you a gift. You have your own speaking slots for the coming year. Isn't that great? And guess what? You can trade them if you want to, but if you do, I just ask that you keep me in the loop. When I did this, what I didn't tell people was that I had an understanding of the different progress levels of the different members. And I didn't want all my expert speakers on one night, and I didn't want all my beginning speakers on another night, because I want variety in the meetings. What I wanted to do also was look at how dependable the different members were. Because if I have 4 speakers who always seem to have something come up every time, that's not a very good schedule. So I put some thought into this, and like I said, about 45 minutes to send out to all the members. Now they know. Because one of the most difficult things to do is get somebody to give a speech and you don't give them enough notice. But if they see it coming, 2, 3, 4 meetings ahead, they can be getting ready. it would happen from time to time that people would back out close to the last minute. But if I schedule four and one person backs out, I still got three. Two people back out, I got two, and a club officer can jump in and present a module from the successful club series. And that counts as credit towards the LB. So I'm still doing project speeches. And I discovered that by doing this ahead of time, assigning the rest of the roles as I get closer and closer to the meetings was a little bit less complex.
Question. Mm-hmm. Just, I know your experience, and I probably did the same thing. Where did you put the new members, and how did you fit the new members in that situation?
Oh! You see that blank slot right there? A couple of blank slots throughout would give me spaces in case people came aboard as new members and wanted to give their icebreaker speeches. And the other thing I fully expected to do was after dues collection time is to revise this. You can probably figure out why that is. But I think I put this together once and probably had to revise it a total of two times during the year. But again, you know, during the course of the year, people will come up and say, I'm going to miss the next meeting, but Charlie's got a speech he wants to give. He's going to take my place. Fine. Put him on the agenda. No problem. Okay? Plan ahead and schedule. And the other point that I would make in terms of showcasing these meetings is be sensitive to members who are doing a role for the first time. Be especially sensitive to that. Don't just assume that they read their manual, they read their book, and they know what they're going to do. Over the years, we have put together in our club a series of, for each role, mistakes commonly made by people when they do the role, how to prepare prior to the meeting, what to do during the meeting, and certain protocols to follow. And when they're going to be doing the role, we send that out to them. And we don't send them 15 attachments, because when you get an email with 15 attachments, what's your natural tendency? I'll look at it later, right? But we actually copy the text and paste it into the message and send it to them, and then follow up so that they're prepared for the meeting. And one of the last things we always put in that text is, take the off-counter check sheet, put it in your CL manual, put it on the coffee table where you'll be sure to remember it on your way out the door tomorrow, and bring it with you to the meeting. Always encourage people to bring their CL manual to the meetings with everything they do. So, showcase your meetings. And when you showcase the meetings, here's what's going to happen. Guests will come, they will like what they see, and they will join. That will help membership. Members will see these as positive experiences, well worth their investment of time and energy, and your attendance will improve. Because attendance is directly correlated with the likelihood of renewing, retention will improve. And if you're having showcase meetings with project speeches on a regular basis, can't help but turn in CCs and ACs and meet your club objectives.